stopped.
We built this city. We built this city on sausage roll.
Build this city.
Come on, babe.
We built this city on sausage rolls.
Don't mind that.
Sorry. Malaria strike up online.
Stay in tune.
If you've never had one, I don't recognize the taste. It's a cylindrical Peter Paul corrupt in a puff pastry case. Beige bits are golden, holier than grace. Grab it whilst it's piping hot and
shove it in your face.
That's
right, so as you can see, that's now starting.
touch of oil in, because you can see it's a little bit shiny, but you don't want it too oily and you don't want it too dry, because otherwise it becomes a problem when you're trying to clean it up. So that's the blue done. Right, Heidi, next colour we're going to do is a bit of orange. Yeah. So let's put the lid on.
Well, I'll squeeze it all in next time.
No, we don't need a lot for this one.
Okay.
Put a clean, different glove on. I think you need a bit more than that, Heidi. Try a bit more for me.
Whoa. That's enough.
That's enough?
That's enough.
Heidi and her food dye.
Mummy gave it to me.
Right, so now we've added the orange in. We're mixing that through.
Lost that little piece. The little piece.
So keep going till it's all mixed through. Oh, that looks a good colour, Heidi. A bit more. Squidge a bit more in for me. Right, that's enough.
Why is it red? It's turning orange.
It's nice and orange. Right, now Bronwyn's going to have a turn at doing some food dyeing.
My food dye.
Right, put the lid back on that one. Right, Bronwyn, can you do us a bit of pink in this one? Bronwyn. Come on, girl, give it a squidge. Right. So now the pink's going in. Let's mix this through. Oh, it's starting to go pink. A bit more, Bronwyn, I think. Add some more in for me.
There's much in
I think it's because Heidi's been using so much of it over the last couple of weeks. We're running out of food colours. Right, so now we've got some nice pink coming through. And the last colour we've got is yellow bombing. So can you put that one in for me?
Let's make a lemon.
Right, so we've got the pink there. Big squeeze. Right, big squeeze at the bottom. That's it, and that's the yellow going in. We might need more bombers to keep the lid off. All right, start, look at that lovely yellow coming through. Some more, bit. We need a bit more. Right, so you could put your food colour, your spaghetti in a Ziploc bag and just massage it through, but you can see how easy it is to make just in the bowls. And then, obviously, if you want to keep it and transport it around, it would go in a Ziploc bag. Right, girls, now we're going to build the rainbow. So I'm going to take my gloves off. Right. So, what colour are we going to have at the top?
Orange or pink?
I think we'll start with the blue. So let's move this here. Can you put them on the floor for me? And that one. Right, so. Obviously, you can make all your different spaghettis the colour of the rainbow. I'm just working with what I've got available in my cupboard at the moment. Right, what's next?
I want to do the red pink.
Hang on. It's the pink one. Okay, so we've got the pink. And then we're going to, can you put that one down on the floor for me? We're going to do some orange. Orange is in.
And then
we're going to put the yellow down. Oh, we've got quite a lot of yellow here, haven't we?
I've got dye on me.
Oh dear. Right, now the girls are going to
make a cloud.
They're going to make the cloud, so I'm going to let them loose. Gonna let them loose with the crazy soap.
Yes.
So I need some clouds here, girls. Whoa! Put them on there. Wow, Heidi, that's a good. That's enough from them. That's enough. That's plenty. Wow! That's enough, Heidi.
Come on.
No, that's enough, please. Your tray, so here's your little rainbow. You can put rainbow toys out, you can put some laminates out, you can put some pots out and different colours. Isn't that both great? Girls, doesn't it? Can make that. Right. Brilliant. So that's how you can make your spaghetti. You can dye your normal pasta, any cooked materials really. It's really simple to make. Obviously it's taste safe. You can get gluten-free spaghetti as well, so you can try different ones out at home. But look at those big fluffy clouds.
Whoa. It's a paper fluffy, I'm gonna die.
So now we're gonna show you how to make chocolate gloop. And I'm gonna put the chocolate gloop here at the bottom of the tray. So it's not what I would usually do, but obviously we wanted to show you it on the tray. So what we're gonna need for that one is chocolate and corn flour. And then we've got some lovely little marshmallows to put on top. Right, so let's put the corn flour in the bowl. Oh, this is going to be fun cleaning this out of the living room today.
You can eat your way through.
Yeah. we're going to add some of that in, some water.
Yeah, what? If you can.
And add your chocolate powder in. I won't add too much. We might want to have a hot chocolate later.
Hey, guess what? If you had so much and you put it on the tray and you didn't want to get rid of it, just eat it in your stomach.
Nice. And then mix through the chocolate powder in with the corn flour. And then you start creating your own chocolate gloop. Oh, this is, look, it smells nice. Well, this is taste safe, but it's corn flour, so you probably wouldn't want to eat it just on its own.
Just want to eat it.
So mix it through. Mm. Oh, it smells nice.
Oh, let me try it. Oh. I'm going to try it now.
Look at this. Oh, so you're getting a nice chocolatey corn flour gloop. Oh, what are you doing, Heidi?
I'm trying to stick my tongue in it.
And that's as simple as it goes. Now, you can pour that on the tray, and then you can add some marshmallows. I'm going to give the girls a marshmallow to keep them busy. Here, eat that. You can add your marshmallows, and then pour it onto your tray and put them on. And then you can put some little tea set out and have yourself a little hot chocolate party. How cool would that be? And it smells delicious.
I want to eat it now.
Right, so that's how you make rainbow spaghetti and chocolate gloop. Other activities you could try at home, which is always a big hit at our toys party, is a vegetable garden. So get yourself some topsoil, plant some vegetables in, do some seeds, get some digging toys, and they could create their own garden. You could make Play-Doh. We've showed you how to make Play-Doh in a previous video, so you can make Play-Doh. You could do your own car wash, because obviously the cars are always a big hit at our session. So get yourself a tray out, put loads of bubble bath in, squish it all in, put sponges in, put the cars in, and let the kids play having a car wash. You could do water beads with frogs, which is always really popular at our sessions. And those are some fantastic other activities you could do for the mess around party. And we also have some fantastic arts and crafts activities that the franchisees across the country have been working on this week. So here's what we made. It's really good fun. So we've made these cute little cars out of egg boxes. Mess Around Surrey created these. They're really, really cute. And we'll have them in our activity blog this week. And you can create your own little road, little stations, and the little cars go around. We also made these really cute little dinosaur footprints with the girls yesterday, and Heidi said it was very tickly making them. So two footprints, we put some sequins on, but you could just draw the teeth in, and some googly eyes. So that was really good fun, because dinosaurs are always a big hit at our parties.
You mean dragons?
Dragon, that's a dinosaur. We also made this frog. Hello, my name is Mr. Frog. Paper plate, you know we love a paper plate here at Mess Around. So here's one we made with a frog, so he's good fun to make. We also made this really cute little duck out of toilet roll, so that's really good. Toilet roll holder, some feathers, some googly eyes. And then we've also got our fantastic little Mess Around spider, which is always good fun. So that's really cool. Bit of card, black card, some googly eyes on that one. And then
the
penguins, which are always a big hit at our Mess Around party. The penguins out on their little hill, little mountain, with some cotton wool, a bowl, and some card and stuff. So we're going to put that in the activity blog and show you how to make that. So other ideas you could try is the Tuff Tray ideas, which is gloopy penguins. So we've just shown you how to make the gloop.
I want to eat it.
So you could put out all the gloop on your Tuff Tray, put all your penguins in, freeze some ice and put some ice in, and then that's a really good activity on the Tuff Tray. You could do shaving foam ducks, so cover your whole tray in shaving foam and then put all the little plastic ducks in. You can also do cereals with trucks, so create your own cereal tray, put all the cars and trucks and the kids can roll over the cereal and get all the crunching sound. And then if you're feeling brave, you can always do, get the beans out, the baked beans out with the dinosaurs and create your own like volcano beans, which is always a big hit at our sessions. So that's 16 activities that you could do at home this week to create your own little fun mess around party with all your toys. So get all your favourite toys out, kids, and then get exploring with all the different materials. And I think we're ready to finish off the show now, aren't we? Yes, so come on girls, let's do it. Let's finish off with our We Like to Party. So when you're at home, you can get partying all week with all these different activities. Post your pictures, post your videos, we would love to see them. And we'll see you soon for our next
event. We like to party. We like to party. We like to party. We like to party.